إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. اللهم اهدنا إلى ما تحبه وترضى يا رب العالمين. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم في سورة آل عمران: يا أيها الذين آمنوا. And every time, my brothers and my sisters, you hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying يا أيها الذين آمنوا, you are supposed to say نعم يا ربي. Yes, Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls us يَا أَيُّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُونَ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Be conscious of Allah in the best way possible. And this is taqwa, is a very important characteristic of a Muslim. A Muslim has to have taqwa. And taqwa is not a spiritual mentality, or it is not an intellectual theory. It's an attitude towards life. You live with taqwa. Your relationship with your surroundings is colored with taqwa. Your attitude to your work ethics is also taqwa. Your relationship to your family is also covered with taqwa. Taqwa is a way of life. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He calls us to have this taqwa, Allah gives us specifications of this taqwa. What are the specifications of the taqwa? In the same surah, in another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls upon us to run fast towards Jannah. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This Jannah, paradise, heaven, is prepared for al-muttaqeen. Ya Allah, who are those muttaqeen? In this ayat, also on Surah Al-Imran, Allah speaks specifically about al-muttaqeen, those who have taqwa in their mind, taqwa in their heart, and taqwa in their attitude. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who are spending for the sake of Allah in time of ease and at time of difficulty. Because you don't spend according to your whims or according to your desire. This money that you have is a gift to you by Allah. Don't think that نَمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمِ عِلْمِ. Don't look like Qarun, say, oh, I got this money because I worked hard. Okay, but how did you work hard? It is the power that was given to you as a gift by Allah. So you and the money you have are entrusted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Then another characteristic, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ. Allah, those who control their anger, كَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ. غَيْظ, almost like fire inside you, and then you control it, you submit it, you make your anger get directed towards what Allah, not what your desire wants you to do. أَلْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ. My brothers and my sisters, الكاظمين الغيظ. جاء رجل إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال له يا رسول الله انصحني. قال لا تغضب، don't get angry. قال يا رسول الله انصحني. قال لا تغضب. قال يا رسول الله انصحني for the third time. الرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تزم don't get angry. والقابلين الله. My brothers and my sisters, we receive messages from families that some Muslim families, some children, Muslim children, get mistreatment, either from the father or from the mother. As a Muslim parent, as a Muslim father, as a Muslim mother, you have to have the attitude of a Muslim in relationship to everything you have, and in relationship with everyone you deal with. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes, gives us a good description for a good family life. خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. The best among you is the best to his family. وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, and he, that Rasulullah is the best to his family. He used to hate his wife. He used to do house and chores. Rasulullah, the one who, the messenger of Allah, Al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wassalam, used to do home chores, used to help his wife. Can you imagine? Imagine if you are a CEO, do you have time to help your wife, your children? And this is the characteristic we need to develop. Please, believe me, Islam is not about salah 5 times a day. Islam is a way of love. There's an attitude towards everyone and everything you deal with. Please, for the sake of Allah, take care of your spouse. Treat them well. Treat them nice. Help them if they need education. Help them if they need to do something for themselves. Help them because your wife is the example of your children. You mistreat your wife, you teach your children very negative characteristic that your wife is not, your mother is nothing. And if their mother is nothing, they will be nothing, then they will be defeated in the life challenges because they don't have a good example at home. My brothers and my sisters, Islam teaches us honor, dignity in ourselves and in relationship to everyone. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ لَمُضْغَةٍ إِذَا صَلْحَتْ صَلْحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلِّهِ. In you, self, there is an organ. It is not the physical organ, it is the spiritual organ, the heart. If it is right, the whole body is right. My brothers and my sisters, we need to take care of our attitudes in relationship to our families, in relationship to our children. We are all responsible beings. And to be able to have a good, healthy society, we need to have a good, healthy family. We need to have good family relations. And my advice to my young brothers and sisters, please, before you get married, make sure that marriage is not a piece of cake. Marriage is a great thing to achieve, but it is also a great responsibility. I don't want younger brothers and sisters to be infatuated by physical desires and forget the responsibilities. And after a year or two, they run into problems, then they decide divorce. Divorce rate among young Muslims is high. And the reason is because we got into marriage without psychological, intellectual, education, spiritual preparation. We need to prepare ourselves for this stage, which is considered to be the most important stage we all have in our life. Your marriage will either make you or break you. You always try to make your marriage a success, but can it fail? Of course it can. But if it fails, never let it break you.
Almost nature pushes you forward so that you can continue, never lose your Islam in case that qadar Allah, some problems happen in your marriage. My brothers and my sisters, with this understanding of the essence of Islam, we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants our life to be covered with Islam. Not just the time we come to Salah, but the time we go outside, the time we go in the business, the time we do our job. If you're a businessman, if you're a medical doctor, if you're a student, if you're an engineer, you need to show the best of Islam. Show the best of Islam in the way you act, your attitude. You remember the brother who came here and accepted Islam a few weeks ago? Do you remember the words he said? What made him accept Islam was the devotion of young Muslim students. Da'wah is not by the words you utter. Da'wah is by the attitude you develop. And that's why Sayyida Aisha, Radwanullahi alayha, when she was asking about the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, summarized it in three words. كان خلقه القرآن. You want to know Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Study the Quran. My brothers and my sisters, three things we need to do. Number one, we need to reconnect with Islam. We need to develop our relationship with Islam on new ground. We are all, almost all of us, are born into Muslim families. I came to be called Muhammad or Ahmed or Ali because it was given to me. I was also, when I was young, he taught me how to eat with my right hand, how to make wudu, and then how to make salah. But when we grow up, we have to make a choice, my brothers and my sisters. And you already made a choice because you are here. No one forces you to come. So number one, we need to reconnect with the message of Islam in our daily life, in our personal life, in our relationships, all relationships. Number two, once we reconnect with Islam, Islam needs to be a living reality. Islam, people will know that you're a Muslim without telling them that you are a Muslim. Number three, which I would like to spend a few more minutes on, is sharing Islam. Two characteristics of a Muslim. A Muslim has to know time and space. Please focus with me on this time. If you don't know the time, and you don't know the space, you are not connecting with Islam. What does it mean? Now, it's almost 1:30. Can we pray Jum'ah at 2 o'clock a.m.? Impossible. Can we pray Jum'ah at 7 p.m.? Impossible. So as a Muslim, before you come, you know what is the time. That's why you need to come on time. That is a very crucial attitude for a Muslim. A Muslim is always connected with the divine. You're always connected with what time is it now. But time itself is not enough. A Muslim has to be connected with his space, with direction. Can we pray this way? Can we pray this way? Can we pray this way? No. There is a specific direction we pray. And we have to be conscious of time and direction. Now, to be concerned about time and concern and direction, we need to know the circumstances in which we are in. Muslim scholars say, listen to this. If a Muslim goes to a place where there is a lot of oppression, and then you teach the Muslim how to make wudu, you are betraying the message of Islam. If you go and see there is a serious problem in the community, and you talk about something that is not relevant, you are betraying the message of Islam. The message of Islam has to be relevant. What is the relevance now? What is this moment is telling to Muslims now? The moment that we are living here, there was supposed to be a crisis. It's called the Muslim ban. It was supposed to create a crisis in the Muslim community. Alhamdulillah, it became an opportunity for Muslims to let the rest of the world know about Islam. When Allah describes you, you've come to be the best ummah, produced for mankind, you are the best ummah at the time of ease and at the time of difficulty. And now Muslims are at the time of difficulty. You need not to be reactionary. You need not to react only. You know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Sayyidina Musa? You know Musa, Nabiullah Musa. One third of the Quran is about the story of Moses and Fir'aun. You cannot have Musa without Fir'aun. You have to have both of them. But what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell Sayyidina Musa? Allah told Sayyidina Musa, Allah did not tell Sayyidina Musa to go and build a school. Ya Musa, go and build a hospital. Egyptians needed hospitals and needed schools. Allah did not tell Musa, go and build the charity somewhere. He told Musa, اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. Go to the Pharaoh. Go to the Pharaoh because it went beyond limits. It is transgressing. It is oppressing. That's why you need to go. That was relevant. Now, what is relevant for us, my brothers and my sister? I don't want to make the long story short. You know what I want to share with you. It is time to share Islam. We need to share Islam with everyone that we get in touch with. You are all professionals. You all have American mates. You all have American office workers, co-workers, office mates. We, inshallah, here are planning to make March 25th. We have more, about 5 weeks from now, an open house for you people, for your friends. We will have the invitation cards ready, inshallah, by next week. We would like every one of you to take 5 cards, 10 cards, and you just give them. Tell them the Muslim community, the Islamic Center, is having an open house. If they come, we welcome them, we talk about Islam, we want the whole world to know about Islam. Now is the relevant time. We are not interested in converting people to Islam. Let me make sure. We're not really in conversion business. We have so many, we have 1.8 billion. What we want is we want people to understand Islam. My brothers and my sisters, listen to Allah. Allah is telling you, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than the one who calls for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We want people to know Islam. It is the right moment. We've never had this moment before in America. This is the best moment. People are interested in listening about Islam. Can you believe we couldn't even pray in the airport? Many of us used to pray in the airport sitting on the chairs. Now you have thousands of Muslims praying in the airport surrounded by Americans, good Americans, who are cheering them up and encouraging them to live like Muslims. It's a moment we need to seize. It's a moment that we need to pay attention to. If you're a teacher, talk to the school. We will be visiting every place we can. Every place we can. Yes, last night we had the police chief spending 2.5 hours with us here. We are planning to invite the mayor, the senator, the congress, the school. We will be visiting the hospital. We will be visiting any place you ask us to visit. And we want you to do your job too. Couple of things I would like to share with them after the end of Salah. My brothers and my sisters, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنِ آدَمِ انْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثِ. When we all die, your relationship to this life suspends, ends, except with the 3 things, صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ, a running charity, عِلْمٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ, good knowledge you leave, scientific, scholarly, or otherwise. وَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ يَدْعُ لَهُ. وَلَدْ أُرْبِدْ. Your children. If you have good children, they will continue praying for you when you pass away. But if you don't have children, or your children are grown up, or your children are not the best, you can also invest in running a charity. You know, الدال على الخير كفاعل. When you contribute to a da'wah project, or when you contribute to a school, to any project you contribute to, you are contributing to running a charity. My brothers and my sister, Allah is gifting you with lots of gifts. When you share it, Allah will increase it. Allah says, مَا نَقَصَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ says, مَا نَقَصَ مَالُ عَبْدٍ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ. Your money will never decrease from a charity. The more you give, the more Allah gives you. So running a charity, knowledge that benefits, and a son or a daughter that can pray for you, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to become better Muslims. فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا لَعَلَّا تَكُونُ لَحْصَةَ إِجَابَةً. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. My brothers and my sisters, as Muslims came from different walks of life, came from different backgrounds, you are all welcome. This is the house of Allah. This house does not belong to any particular group or any particular one. This is your house. And we are trying here to help one another. We are planning, inshallah, to have a Quranic study class for those who are interested. If you are not on our mailing list, please leave your information so that we communicate with you about the programs we are doing. We are having a Seerah class tonight. The Seerah class tonight will discuss the interfaith, the etiquette of interfaith. What do we need to know when we speak about Islam? We will study the story of Ja'far ibn Abi Talib when he was sent from Mecca because of torture in Mecca to Abyssinia, to Somalia nowadays, or Ethiopia already. Let us come together so that we can study. And we will be doing other programs. You have to be part of it. You have to be part of the solution. So leave your email, leave your phone number, fill out. We have a weekend school. Please participate. If you're a children, do not go to a weekend school. You have to send them to a week. Any weekend school will be good school, inshallah, for your children. My brothers and my sisters, the summary of this khutbah is, we need to reconnect with Islam. We need to live Islam. Islam is not a theory, Islam is a practice, is a way of life. And the third one is we need to share Islam. We share Islam not only by speaking, but we share Islam by attitude, by the way we behave, that the way we act with other people. If we act positively, people are going to say, who is this? Why is he or she doing this? That is because Islam teaches you to become a better human being. This is a good moment for all of us to participate in the da'wah. There was a conversation between the shaytan and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The shaytan told Allah, by my honor, I will mislead those who believe in you. And you know what was the response of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, by my honor and my power, I will forgive everyone who seeks forgiveness. Allah. Allah. Isn't it time we ask Allah to forgive us? Oh Allah, forgive all our sins and mistakes. Oh Allah, help us to become better Muslims. Oh Allah, help us to love one another. Oh Allah, help us to work for Islam. Oh Allah, help us to share the message of Islam. Oh Allah, enrich us spiritually. Oh Allah, enrich us socially. Allahumma ihdina fi man hadayta wa tawallana fi man tawallayta wa barik illahumma lana ya rabbi fi ma a'tayta wa qina wasrif 'anna sharra ma qadayta. Allahumma atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina 'adhab an-nar. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واقيموا الصلاه.
اللهم اكبر. اشهد ان لا اله الا الله. اشهد ان محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاه حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله استقيم يرحمنا ويرحمكم الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم